Hello, my name is Colin Jamora. I head the EFON InSTEM Joint Research Laboratory. We are housed in the Center for Inflammation and Tissue Homeostasis at the Institute for Stem Cell Biology and Regenerative Medicine in Bangalore, India. Together with my graduate student, Neha, we will provide a snapshot of our recently published work in the Journal of Clinical Investigation titled PI-1 Mediates Fibroblast Mast Cell Interactions in Skin Fibrosis. As the main protective barrier from the external environment, our skin is frequently subjected to damage and injury, and the long-lasting evidence of this is the formation of scars. This scar is a result of deposition of proteins called the extracellular matrix, with collagen being the most widely known of this class of proteins. The cells that secrete collagen are called fibroblasts, and upon wound healing, fibroblasts produce extra amounts of collagen and other extracellular matrix proteins to form a scaffold that provides structural support to the damaged skin. Normally, these activated fibroblasts are switched off or eliminated at the end of the wound healing response. But under certain conditions, these cells remain hyperactive for a prolonged period of time. This condition, where hyperactive fibroblasts produce too much collagen and other extracellular matrix proteins, is called fibrosis. The accumulation of collagen can lead to the hardening of the tissue, which results in compromised tissue function or even organ failure. Fibrosis can affect almost every organ of the body. Different fibrotic diseases include cystic fibrosis, affecting the lungs, cardiac fibrosis, which affects normal heart functioning after a heart attack, diabetic retinopathy, which affects the vision, and keloids in the skin. The widespread incidence of fibrosis is evident in the fact that nearly one-third of all deaths worldwide have fibrosis as a contributing factor. Despite this international prevalence, there are no effective treatments to cure fibrosis. One way of combating this pathology is to inactivate the fibroblasts that secrete collagens. Our strategy for turning fibroblasts off is to understand the mechanisms that turn them on in the first place. Interestingly, a common feature of fibrotic tissues is inflammation. We therefore hypothesize that the immune cells that are responsible for inflammation may also play a role in activating fibroblasts and keeping them on for an excessive amount of time. To test this hypothesis, we utilized a genetically engineered mouse model that develops skin fibrosis. In humans, fibrosis in the skin is a disease called scleroderma. As you can observe, when compared to normal skin, scleroderma skin appears highly thickened, which is indicative of excessive amounts of collagen being secreted from the fibroblasts in the dermis. Our mouse model of skin fibrosis also exhibits the same symptom of the human fibrotic skin. We are thus in a position to utilize this mouse to perform experiments to understand the molecular mechanisms underlying fibrosis development.
Our experiments showed that the levels of a protein called the plasminogen activator inhibitor type 1, or PI-1, is high in the fibrotic mouse skin compared to the normal mouse skin.
Although commonly known to function in the removal of blood clots during the wound healing process, this protein is known to be highly expressed in a multitude of human fibrotic diseases, including cystic fibrosis, cardiac fibrosis, and liver fibrosis. However, how a protein classically known to be involved in the removal of blood clots contributes to fibrosis is unknown.
To first test whether PI-1 contributes to skin fibrosis, we removed the gene that encodes PI-1 in our mouse model and asked whether the mice still developed skin fibrosis. Interestingly, we observed that the removal of PI-1 led to a significant block in the development of skin fibrosis. Our hypothesis is that inflammatory cells play a role in activating the fibroblast, so we tested whether PI-1 was reducing fibroblast activity by affecting immune cells in the skin. We found that the numbers of a particular type of immune cell called mast cells are dependent upon PI-1 in the fibrotic skin. Now, mast cells are best known for releasing compounds that induce inflammation, such as histamine, which causes an allergic reaction in the body. But they have also been observed to be present in high numbers in all fibrotic conditions. Based upon this preliminary discovery, we have now shown that PI-1 can act as a substance that attracts mast cells into the skin. What then are these mast cells doing in the fibrotic skin? We had observed in the skin fibrotic condition called scleroderma that mast cells and fibroblasts are in close contact with each other, as you can observe in these images taken with an electron microscope. This association is absent in the wild-type mouse skin. Interestingly, in the snail transgenic fibrotic mouse skin, we saw that the mast cells form points of contact with the dermal fibroblasts, as it does in human scleroderma skin. So now that we knew that Pi-1 can cause increased infiltration of mast cells into the skin and make them attach to the fibroblasts, we started probing the effect of the adhesion of mast cells to fibroblasts. We have shown that the physical adhesion of mast cells to fibroblasts can lead to the hyperactivation of the fibroblasts. The attached mast cells themselves also become activated and secrete certain substances, which increases the number of activated fibroblasts. This work has identified a number of new players in the progression of fibrosis. This is important new information as it provides potential new avenues of therapeutic intervention, which are currently sorely lacking.
We have provided a snapshot of our findings, and the molecular details can be found in our manuscript.